Looking west from the Conrail Bridge, one will find a stretch of bared rock along the northern bank of the Ohio River. This seemingly ordinary expanse of rock is actually one of the world's largest exposed Devonian period fossil beds and is the main attraction to the Falls of the Ohio State Park. Customary to Midwest rivers, the area today is teeming with waterfowl and the usual plant life. But 387 million years ago, this region would have been under a shallow tropical sea, and the surrounding landscape would have actually been blanketed by a prehistoric coral reef. The ancient reef sat on a layer of limestone, and as the remains of the area's marine life settled on the sea's floor, they would become petrified in the limey stone and then entombed under sediment deposits, where they would remain for several ice ages, until the meltwaters from receding glaciers would carve out the Ohio River Valley, removing the layers of rock and sediment covering the fossilized coral seafloor. The particular type of limestone found here is called Jefferson limestone, and it's well known for its fossil density and preservation of fossils in life positions. Because of this, it's no surprise that well over 100 different species of prehistoric marine wildlife have been discovered fossilized in the rock ledges that make up this amazing natural wonder. These unique ancient fossil beds serve not only as a history lesson of life before man, but also have helped shape the modern world as well. This is because the Falls of the Ohio isn't really a waterfall, but a series of rapids made up of the very limestone ledges that also house the fossilized reef bed. These rapids descend 26 feet in elevation over a 2-mile length of the Ohio, making traveling downriver very difficult during low river levels. So difficult, in fact, that it was the only natural barrier along the entire river, which meant traders and merchants had to stop here to portage goods or wait for the river to rise. This stopping point would later expand into the cities of Clarksville and Jeffersonville, Indiana, and Louisville, Kentucky. As a result of channeling of the river through a series of locks and dams completed in 1830, access to the archaeological site improved, preserving this ancient marvel for generations to come.